I, Nelson Rodesasa Mandela.
Nelson Mandela Tata Madiba passed away December 5th at the age of 95 and was memorialized by world leaders and millions everywhere as a positive force for peace.
The individual whites who are fighting the principle, are fighting white domination. And in the course of that struggle, we can even form friendships with people from the other side.
His unrelenting perseverance against apartheid through decades of imprisonment and isolation inspired the world to join his fight. He was not only the father of the Rainbow Nation, South Africa, but father to a global movement of equality for everyone, regardless of sex, race, orientation, or religion.
Let me tell you a story about when I was a little girl. There was no place I had in the world. Any place we would settle down, I would be ripped from there, no feet on the ground. The one constant thing I had was a strong feeling towards people. It was healing. At the time, they may have been misconstrued as hate. I found out it was compassion, but not too late. I tried to fight the world, but realized I was outnumbered. There was a feeling in my heart that hungered to help people who couldn't help themselves. But I didn't realize this until I needed help the most. Now to the summer after my sophomore year, almost 16, I had friends and family that covered me with the warm blanket of their love. I'm very dependent on this blanket of their warm embrace, which I soon found out when she left without a trace. An important piece of fabric passed on, unraveling at the seams of my security to the point where I was defenseless, trying to hurt myself every night, leaving me breathless. Alone and afraid, it was hard to find the method that once helped me reside. In the world, I couldn't stand up to anything for anything. Leaving me without defense, I was left to my enemies, throwing punches, holding back, no expense. When hurting myself didn't feel good anymore, I needed something else to patch the void. The crutch I used was giving back to the people I abused. Helping with nickels and dimes, or maybe giving them some of my time. Before I could breathe, senior year was here. It was the hardest in more ways than one. The void is back stronger than ever, coming and going whenever. Sometimes I feel like lying down and doing nothing, not a single urge to do something. The only thing that keeps me going is that people rely on me. I don't particularly care where I end up. If I help others, I help myself. And to me, that's the key to growing up. Helping those around me is all I ever wanted to do. And Nana, I want to let you know it's all for you.
Hey Jags, Ari Martinez here with DVTV on December 19th of 2013. So let's get started. For events this week, we have the activities with our school's winter concert featuring DV band and orchestra. Then we'll head on over to sports with an interview with our school's wrestling instructor who will give us some insight on the program. See the action right here.
Desert View High School Music Program presents their annual winter concert featuring acts such as Winter Guard, who choreographed a routine to Mariah Carey's All I Want for Christmas Is You. The next act to follow was choir, who sang Ave Maria, Hallelujah, and A Whole New World, to name a few, including solos from Darielis Solis and Jesus Valenzuela León. We also had a performance from orchestra, which featured Dance of Toy Flutes, Rumming Nations, Symphony Espagnole, and dueling jingle strings. Percussion ensemble was next with the themes from Mortal Kombat and Super Mario Medley. Jazz band was next with an astonishing 7 songs, with solos from Sergio Tepanico, Alexis Alde, Manny Castillo, Jamie Arines, Aaron Vargas, and Miguel Angel Gallego. Last but certainly not least, Desert View's concert band was up, coming back from a long marching season, being able to present their 3 songs: Jesus, Joy of Man's Desiring, The Phantom of Dark Hollow, and Sleigh Ride. Thanks, Jaguars, for showing up and giving your support. Stay posted for our music program's next event. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Coach Lozano. I'm the wrestling coach at Desert View. I've been coaching here for 3 years now. Our season is off to a great start. We have kids who are producing. We're still looking for wrestlers to come out, so if you're interested in joining, please come out for the wrestling team. Wrestlers so far who have set themselves apart, we have Chantro Hill, who's a sophomore, who wrestles 106. He plays second at the William Bow and fifth at the Choyo Duels. We also have Jacob Landovasso, who is a senior, who is exemplifying a lot of senior leadership. He took third at the William Bow. As a team, we're struggling to win matches because we don't have the numbers as other teams do. But individual-wise, we're competing well, and kids are really winning matches on an individual basis as a team. We're kind of struggling, like I said, because of numbers. So if you're interested in wrestling, come out and help the team and get us going.
My name is Rene Gomez. I'm a wrestler here at Desert View, 182-pound weight class. And you know, so far I've been really proud of this season. Got a lot of wins under my belt, not too many losses. Real proud of all the young kids. We need a lot more. We need to win as a team. We're the only team in the school that has 3 state championships. We got a hell of a coach this year. He's consistent, and we got what it takes. Just need more people.
You know, our next home match is January 22nd. It'll be senior night here at Desert View Gymnasium. And we'll have 5 teams here, Benson, Poston Butte, the team from Phoenix. We're looking for a real good crowd to come out, support the team, honor our seniors, and to get that Desert View Jaguar pride out here while supporting the wrestling program.
Thanks for supporting your music groups at their last concert of the year. Also, go to all your DV wrestling matches to show us the boys some support. Next up, we have academics with a special video if you're interested in scholarships, which you should be. And close, we have interview leader in trio and upward bound program. See it all right now.
What's up, guys? This is your student interest segment in our academic segment.
Segmentation.
And I'm here to help you. Or tell you someone who will help you. Check out College Greenlight at the link below to get tons of different scholarships that match you. By making an account and filling in your information, the site will find different colleges and scholarship matches that best fit your preferences. And the more you fill in, the more matches you'll get. So let's say I type in, professional sandwich maker, and press search. I suppose if there was any scholarships, they'd show up for sandwich. Well, let's say I type in cinematography, and boom, I have tons of different scholarships about filming and such, which I've already applied for. The site gives you detailed information about each scholarship and gives links to the official pages they're posted on. Then you can consume every detail. Sweet, delicate details. So what are you waiting for? Type in the link below to sign up. It's free and easy, like something that's really easy. Just do it already. Go on. I know you need college monies. I mean, look at you.
Alright, just cut that.
Go! Stop watching the show. This is college. It's college, man. Alright, anyways, thanks for watching.
My name is Carlos Romero. I'm the program coordinator for Upward Bound here at Desert View High School and also at Sunnyside as well. We are a college preparatory program. So what we do is we help our students get to college pretty much in any way we can. So we help them fill out the FAFSA, we help them apply for schools, we help them apply for scholarships, we help them identify the schools, you know, that their scores and grades might get them accepted to, and other things of that nature. Right now, we are the number one ranked Upward Bound in the state of Arizona, and that's according to the Department of Education, because we've met our objectives more than any other Upward Bound program in the state. There's 3 main components to our program. Number one is tutoring. So every grade of B or below in any core class, our students are required to do 1 hour of tutoring per week, and we provide the tutor for them. Second thing we do is our Saturday enrichment classes. What those do is we take them to Pima College, and for 12 Saturdays throughout the school year, they take 3 classes, one in math, one in literature, and one in science. And that's to help them score better on the AIMS test and also score as high as they can on the SAT and the ACT tests. The third thing we do is our 6-week summer program. It always starts the day after Memorial Day and it goes through the first week of July. It's similar to our Saturday classes in that the students come to Pima College, But it is like a regular high school day. They're on campus from about 9 to 2 p.m. They take four classes. We do try to offer classes that aren't offered here normally at Desert View. In the past, we've done architecture, we've done a Chinese class, we've done a building your own business class, and other things of that nature. Beyond that, you know, we're pretty much, you know, just do whatever we can to get our students into college. You don't need to have straight A's to be in the program. The main thing we look for is a drive to get to college, a work ethic to improve yourself, and the willingness to participate and do what we ask, you know, in order to get to college. That's pretty much what we look for in a nutshell.
Make sure to apply to the colleges of your choice and stay updated on any surrounding admission and scholarships. Next up, we have our special segments with a documentary-style video and our Campus Canvas segment showcasing one of the amazing artists here on DV. Watch it all right now.
And now for the amazingly exciting documentary you've been waiting for. I'm just kidding. It was too long to put in the show. Go to our YouTube to watch it right now to see an informative video of sorts. But after you watch the show. So finish the show. But afterwards, you're in for a treat. Yeah.
This week on Campus Canvas, Jacob Landavasso.
Hello. my name is Jacob Landavasso, and I'm a senior here this year at Desert View High School, and I'm an artist. What kind of art do I create? I create a decent variety, I would say, of different kinds of art. When I was really young, probably around 4 or 5, drawing, and I drew all sorts of things like when I was small, but it was mostly like animals, and like I would draw sea monsters and stuff like that, and they weren't like impressive really, but for a 4-year-old, I guess people were like, oh, that's cool. So I mean, it was something I really enjoyed doing when I was little, was drawing, and it wasn't until like maybe two years ago that I started like looking at other artwork, like tattoos and paintings and other things, like other kind of artwork such as that. And then I started trying to get into it, so that's when I started painting. So I kind of went off from drawing and started painting. I never had any like classes or anything. I mean, I had a couple classes at school, but it was just for fun, you know. I learned a couple things from my classes, but mostly just self-taught, like drawing. I went from drawing to painting, and then went from painting to airbrushing. My dad got me into that because he's all into cars, and he would show me the airbrushings that they would do, like the murals they'd paint on the cars, and I thought that was really cool. So I got an airbrush kit and started doing airbrushing. And so I mean, I create a lot of different art. I like painting a lot because I mean, I never was really into color so much, but painting kind of got me into using colors. So I mean, yeah, I don't really focus on one thing. Every now and then I'll even grab a piece of wood and just start chipping away at it, just trying to shape something. It's like, I don't know, it's just being creative is art, and I would rather just use like any kind of aspect I can. I don't really focus on one genre, I guess. Well, yeah, I always wanted to do something I enjoyed after high school. Like, I know that I'm gonna have to go out and get a job and stuff like that, but I want to dedicate my life to something that I really enjoy, and art is that something. I mean, I don't just do art. Like, I do music, and I want to do that as well, but I want that to be like my main focus is just art and music when I get out of high school.
If you're interested in being featured on our Campus Canvas, email us on the links below and we'll feature your work right here on the show. To close out the broadcast, we have an original R&B sketch along with a special video created for the show. Remember to wear your IDs around the school and tune into DV for all the latest. Be kind and courteous to your classmates and stay classy, Tucson, Arizona.
Son, I took your Nintendo box away. That will teach you not to get an A minus. Minus? Who does that? Much disrespect, Dad.
Extinction Mode. Oh my freaking gosh. There's an Easter egg. And oh my gosh, you need to play. You need to play it. You need to play. Do you have the Xbox? Where's your Xbox at? Do you have it? Come on, dude. Tell me where's the Xbox at.
What's up, boy?
Son, your teacher was a dirty liar. There was a problem with the grading mechanism, so have your Call of Duty machine back. Some love, Dad.
I, Nelson Hodesasa Mandela.
Nelson Mandela Tata Madiba passed away December 5th at the age of 95 and was memorialized by world leaders and millions everywhere as a positive force for peace.
The individual whites who are fighting the principle, fighting white domination. And in the course of that struggle, we can even form friendships with people from the other side.
His unrelenting perseverance against apartheid through decades of imprisonment and isolation inspired the world to join his fight. He was not only the father of the Rainbow Nation, South Africa, but father to a global movement of equality for everyone, regardless of sex, race, orientation, or religion.
Guys, did you like the show? Well, hit that subscribe button and share it to all your friends. Like us on Facebook.com/DesertViewTV. Subscribe at YouTube.com/DesertViewTV. Follow us on Twitter at DesertViewTV. And follow us on Instagram at DesertViewTV. Have questions or concerns? Any requests? Well, email us at DesertViewTV@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.